early 90s, Wendell Rodrigues has translated Indian fashion and style in his own inimitable way, carving out a niche for ultra-chic, yet relaxed and comfortable clothing. Shunning the predictable hype that regularly surrounds the fashion industry, Rodrigues has quietly gone about creating clothes that reflect a subdued Goan idiom, infused with his own mastery over form and design.
I knew from a very young age that I wanted to be a designer, though I didn't really know that the word existed because I don't think it existed then as a fashion designer. It was basically a tailor or something of that sort. So I think what I did was I went about it the long way, though not necessarily the wrong way. I did a course in hotel management. I worked 6 years in that industry and eventually I saved enough of money to go to Los Angeles and study fashion.
After training in Los Angeles and Paris, Rodrigues first started his design career in Mumbai. In 1993, he moved to Goa with longtime partner Jerome and decided to set up his business amidst a rural setting in his native village of Kolbali. After converting his father's 350-year-old house into the Wendell Rodrigues Design Studio, his journey as India's most creative designer had begun.
He's a very dynamic person, a very alive, very active. He's got his likes and his dislikes. And one of his likes, I think, is Goa. He's very fond of Goa. And so am I, so that is something we have in common.
Living in a place like Goa, I had just no choice but to do things that came naturally to this land. When I started doing clothes that were more relaxed, more easy, even at that time, I didn't really consciously think of the word resort. The word resort came into the clothes.
This move to his roots has defined Rodrigues, his clothes and his career, with a distinct Goan ethos permeating every facet of his work and lifestyle.
For me, his clothes are just the perfect ode to a woman. When I wear a Wendell creation, rest assured, I know I feel like a million bucks. It makes me feel like a woman. It makes me feel sensuous. It's a combination of all of it.
Resort wear has become the hallmark of the Wendell Rodrigues label. With an emphasis on fluid forms and comfortable cuts, his designs echo his sense for chic style combined with the calmness of his environment.
We actually took this whole Goan flavor and translated it onto something that would work in mainstream India. I just felt that with the kind of easy, laid-back lifestyle that we live here in Goa, the clothes became a natural extension of my mind and my lifestyle.
He loves Goa, he loves going in the fields, he loves the house.
Since 1996, Rodrigues and Jerome have been living in a 400-year-old house, which they have gradually done up themselves, preserving the authentic architecture of the structure.
House is beautiful, really. Typical Goan style, you know, you've got upstairs, downstairs, and everything's big.
We've spent all the days that we would shoot in Goa between ourselves in that house. I mean, apart from the shoot itself.
I have many, 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 many fond memories of his house and everything that goes with his house, right from his health to his dogs to just the most divine food that you'll ever, ever, ever have.
Reaffirming his commitment to Goa, Rodrigues recently inaugurated the Wendell Rodrigues Design Space, his flagship retail store in Panjim.
we both like, that we both use in our houses.
When I conceived the new Wendell Rodriguez design space here in Kampal, in this wonderful heritage area, I was very clear that I wanted to do different types of rooms. I mean, I'm in the favorite, in my favorite room now called the white room, because it has everything in white, from the clothes that are hanging on the clothesline to the crockery which is on display. But I also wanted to add certain things which are Wendell Rodriguez's philosophy and beliefs. So there are items from other brands, including skin creams and jewelry and books in this room as well. My favorite object in the entire shop is a little pig that we did. It's the Wendell Rodriguez Goa glamorous pig, which is there. It has a little necklace, tiny little earrings, and it's going to be our bestseller item this season, I'm sure.
Coming up, we'll explore the inspirations behind some of the most breathtaking fashion photographs from the Wendell Rodriguez collection. Throughout his career, Rodriguez has drawn inspiration from his surroundings in Goa, which have touched his work and life alike.
I live in nature and I'm naturally inspired by everything that happens around me. From my early morning walks, I'm always walking around, whether it's in my garden. I could pick up a leaf or the part of a branch and convert that into a blouse. Or I could walk into the fields. And just the movement of the grass and how it almost has like a kind of a rhythmic crinkling in it. I would use that in my clothing. Or the beauty of a really large banyan tree, where I have already imagined a model in it and what kind of clothing the garment will be made in. It's a natural visual translation of what I see around me, of the experience that I have by living in this village, and putting that out on the rack eventually.
This philosophy has resulted in some of the most breathtaking clothes and fashion photographs that have amply exhibited the designer's creativity and innate sense of style.
They've always been magical, absolutely magical. I mean, we go there with the intention of shooting. We always know, okay, let's just shoot some great pictures. But, you know, every single time, it's not just great pictures. They're pictures that you want to have for posterity.
So this is a garden for my inspiration, literally in every sense of the word, where I can use every little bit of element that is there, whether it is the grass on the ground, or in this case, this kind of a very simple part of the coconut tree, which, as you can see, has got like a weave in it, which I have used for like a choli for Madhu Sapre for my shows, and actually created an entire garment based on a fiber that's as natural and as present as this in reality, and moved it onto a creative image.
It's typical Wendell, huh? He probably went down the beach and picked up something and stuck it on her. Now, you know, I think a lot of people could have done that, but somehow when he does it, it looks good.
So this is one of my favorite spots for inspiration, a wide abandoned field where I come here and go over the hill to get my sketchbook out and do collections that are actually based on nature. We've shot Malaika Arora in these fields wearing a ripple blouse, very much like this wind is moving through the dry fields, and the entire effect of this has gone onto a kind of a crinkled organza blouse, which looks very beautiful, especially in this setting.
It's a series where we just went into the fields behind his house.
Put me into this thing and into this little camisole kind of a crush thingy, and he black, and he said, go sit in the fields and do whatever you have to do.
It was not really a setup. It was, I think she was sitting down to, take a break or something, and she was hamming it up for the camera. So I think that's the shot.
This tree has a lot of memories for me, because not only did I do one of my most memorable shoots here, just the ambience of this, this old banyan tree, which almost looks like a hill from far, the quality of light that filters in, the grooves in the wood, which all created a new kind of pleating fabric that I used.
So there's this place that he found whilst walking his dogs or something, and he said you'll just love it because it just has this really sensuous things happening in the back. And lo and behold, he came up with this kind of outfit, which was really just a piece of fabric that went down. And that's his genius, because there's really nothing, I mean, if you look at it, it's just a piece of cloth.
That by far is my most favorite picture. It was this tree that that was always there, and Wendell obviously always knew of it, and Farooq always wanted to shoot over there. We just went there, we saw this tree, this enormous tree, and it just looked so surreal, the whole setting, this huge banyan tree in the middle of nowhere. And he just put me into his clothes and he said, okay, now go stand there and just behave like, just behave like you're one of the many vines hanging from the tree, you know, literally. And that's how the whole picture came about.
For me, it is a very emotional experience to come back to this place, because it's always been a kind of a spiritual place, like most banyan trees are. The entire effect of, you know, going into the roots and going back into nature and finding inspiration, pulling it out and then presenting it to the world at large. It's a great high, and it is also an extremely moving experience for me, because I'm kind of going back to come forward.
The Wendell Roderick signature style is unique in India, blending ancient Indian geometry with a relaxed Goan attitude. Through the years, the designer has gone beyond making clothes and is actively involved in other areas of fashion.
I get into areas of doing new interesting work. I mean, I've done lots of styling campaigns, whether it was for international jewelry, baggage. So these other areas of fashion, which are not necessarily only about the collection. At the moment, I'm doing a research and I've just finished, and I'm doing a book on the history of Goan costume, which has nothing to do with fashion as a collection of garments, which has a completely different side to what I can do with fashion as a base. I hope to open a museum one day based on that same book. So I think all these various areas are facets of fashion, which are progressive and evolving in their own way.
Well, he is just the most loving, giving person I've ever met, a true, true friend. He is what he is. There's no, there's no extra frills. It's very clear, it's very black and white, everything about him. And that's what I absolutely, absolutely adore about him.
Apart from making beautiful clothes, and he always has the Goa vibe, which I really love.
Is one of the most generous human beings that I've met. When I say generous, it's not just in a material sense or in terms of his spirit and his creative processes.
For 16 years, the Wendell Roderick's aura has spread across the fashion world in India and abroad. In 1995, he became the first Indian designer to be chosen for the world's largest garment fair at Igedo in Germany. Since then, his creativity and commitment have made Roderick's one of the most respected names among the country's leading fashion designers, with a pioneering legacy that remains unmatched to this day.
Just very recently, I had to go someplace and I took out one of his creations, which, believe me, it was 10 years old. I wore that outfit 10 years back. I still have it with me, and I don't know what made me want to pull it out. I just took it out and I wore it. It was unbelievable. I met him and I told him, you know, do you remember? Blast from the past, I told him that. And it looked immaculate, whether 10 years back or whether I wore it today, it was eternal. There was absolutely not even the slightest thing that, oh God, it's out of style, it looks strange. That's what his clothes are. His clothes are eternally beautiful.
As a designer, we've been through a vast learning experience in the past 16 years. All of us who actually started this whole kind of journey called fashion design in India. And I think the time has come for us to transcend that kind of pioneering spirit that we began the whole process and leave a legacy behind. Whether the legacy is going to be, in my case, it's going to be like a school or a museum. I think what is important is that the legacy of that style needs to continue. It needs to go out into the world. It needs to make its statement. And for everyone to sit up and say, to record the fact that Wendell Rodericks was a part of that moving history and progress in fashion.
Translating India's rural aesthetic into a modern global context. Wendell Rodericks.